Sai Ram children, good morning. Welcome to online session. We'll start continue with our chapter 2, parallel lines and transversal. So last time we have studied about parallel lines. What are parallel lines? The lines which are in the same plane and do not intersect each other are called parallel lines, right? Okay, so let's recall, it is given in the form of blanks. First one, if a line intersects given two lines in two distinct points, then that line is called a dash of those two lines. So if a line intersects the given lines or two lines in two distinct points, it is called, yes children, answer, transversal. It is called a transversal of those two lines. So answer is transversal. Second one, when two lines are intersected by a transversal, dash angles are formed. So how many angles are formed? Yes, 8 angles. That is, two points of intersection are there, right? So at one point 4 angles, at another point 4. So 8 angles are formed. Now angles made by a transversal, these angles made by a transversal, so the angles are grouped in different pairs of angles, and they are, we have studied yesterday, they are corresponding angles, alternate angles, interior angles. So let's continue. Today we learn about properties of angles. Properties of angles formed by two parallel lines and the transversal. So which type of angles are formed? Corresponding angles, alternate angles, interior angles. So first we will do property of corresponding angles. Each pair of corresponding angles formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is of congruent angles. It means, that is, the property of corresponding angles is, when two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, the angles formed are congruent. That is, corresponding angle, each pair of corresponding angle is congruent. So here it is given the figure. Line PQ is parallel to line RS. So this is given, PQ parallel to RS, and transversal is line AB. Line AB is transversal, and it is intersecting the lines at M and N, two different points, right? And what we have studied, each pair of corresponding angle formed is congruent. So which are the corresponding angles? Corresponding angles, they are on the same side of transversal, right, and the same direction. So first pair is angle AMP, this pair. So second pair with that is first pair. So AMP, and another one is angle MNR. They are in the same direction and same side of the transversal. So these angles are congruent. So angle AMP, this is this angle. Angle AMP is congruent to angle MNR. So how many pairs of corresponding angles are formed? 4 pairs. Second pair is PMN, this one. So it is RNB, this one. So these angles are also congruent. That is PMN and this. PMN and RNB, they are congruent. Third pair is angle AMQ, this one, third pair. AMQ and MNS, so they are, or if you see properly, like letter L is formed, they are in the same direction. So angle AMQ and angle MNS, so they are congruent, third pair. And the fourth pair is, that is this one, QMN, fourth pair, is congruent to SNB, this angle. So fourth pair, these angles are congruent. So what we have to remember, that corresponding angles formed by two parallel lines that is by parallel lines, and the transversal are congruent. So each pair is congruent. Four pairs are formed and they are congruent. So this is a property of corresponding angles. The next type of angles are alternate angles. So property of alternate angles. Each pair of alternate angles formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is of congruent angles. It means the pair of alternate angles formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is congruent. And we have studied alternate angles, interior alternate angles, exterior alternate angles. So, interior alternate angles. Now given line PQ is parallel to line RS and line AB is a transversal. So interior angles, they are inside the parallel lines, inside the given lines, inside the parallel lines, and alternate angles, they are in the opposite direction. So first angle is PMN, this angle PMN, then the other one will be opposite direction, that is MNS, this one. So you can see the letter Z is formed, letter Z, like this. Alternate angles. So first pair PMN, that is PMN and MNS, they are congruent. And next pair is now, that is QMN, it's a second pair. So opposite direction, that is MNR. So these are interior alternate angles. QMN congruent to MNR. So each pair of alternate angles is also congruent. They are interior alternate angles. Two pairs of interior alternate angles are formed. They are congruent. Now exterior alternate angles. So these angles are outer sides of the parallel lines or outer sides of the given lines, right? And in opposite direction. So line PQ is parallel to line RS, line AB is a transversal. So let's see now exterior angles. Which are exterior angles? AMB. And another one will be in opposite direction, outer. So that is SNB. AMB, SNB. So these angles are congruent. And exterior angles also, two pairs of exterior angles are there. And next one is, that is angle AMQ. This one, this is the second one. So another one will be RNB. Remember, alternate angles, they are on the opposite sides, right? And so here also, they are that is exterior alternate angles, so outer sides. So these angles, that is AMQ and RNB, are congruent. And the third type of angles are interior angles. So property of interior angles. Each pair of interior angles formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is of supplementary angles. Now what are supplementary angles? Supplementary angles are when the sum of two angles is 180 degree. So when the measure of two angles is 180 degree. So here interior angles, what is the property now? They are 180 degree. Their sum is 180 degree. So interior angles, line PQ is parallel to line RS. And AB is a transversal. Now interior angles, they are inside the lines, given lines, inside the parallel lines, and same side. So here also one angle is PMN, one this. So another one will be MNR, like that. So they are on the same side and inside the given line. And their sum is 180 degree. It means measure angle PMN and angle PMNR, PMN, and these two angles, that they are 180 degree. Their sum is 180 degree. That is, they are supplementary. When the sum of two angles is 180 degree, they are supplementary. Now next one is next pair, which is the next pair, other side of the transversal, that is QMN, this one. That is angle QMN, this angle. And another angle is MNS. So these two angles is a second pair and their sum is 180 degree. So QMN and MNS is 180 degree. So what is the property of interior angles? The sum of interior angles is 180 degree. Practice set 2.2. First question. Choose the correct alternative. In the adjoining figure, if line M is parallel to N and line P is a transversal, then find X. So which are the parallel lines? Line M is parallel to line M and transversal is P. And we have to find X. Option A is 135 degree, B 90 degree, C 45 degree and D 40 degree. So first what we will do? We will find the given angles, this relation, which type of angles they are. So which type of angles we have studied? Formed by transversal and the given lines, corresponding angles, alternate angles and interior angles. Right? So these angles 3x and x, they are interior angle. They are formed on the same side of transversal and inside the given lines, right? Inner side. So what is the property of interior angles we have studied? Interior angles are supplementary. It means sum of interior angles is 180 degree, right? So what we will do, if you want, if you are able to solve orally, good. Otherwise, do the calculation. That is 3x plus x is equal to 180 degree. It is 180 degree. Now 3x plus 4x is how much it is? 3x plus x. So 4x. 3x plus x, 4x. And 4x is equal to 180 degree. So x is equal to divide 180 by 4. So now you can do the calculation. 4 ones are 4, 4s are 16. Again 2, 20 will be there. So 45. So answer is x is equal to 45 degree. Which option it was? C option. X is equal to 45 degree. Next question. In the adjoining figure, if line A and line B are parallel. Line A is parallel to line B and line L is a transversal, then find X. So these are the two parallel lines and the transversal is L. And we have to find X. Options are A 90 degree, B 60 degree, C 45 degree and D 30 degree. So now we have to find what is the relation between the given angles. So what type of angles they are? Are they corresponding angles? No. Are they alternate angles? No. Are they interior? No. But we have to find. So what we will do is, we will write here. So this angle, they are vertically opposite. So this angle is also 2x. So this is angle is 2x. This is also 2x. The reason is they are vertically opposite. And vertically opposite angles are congruent. Now you see the angles 4s and 2x. Now they have become interior angles. Now they have become interior angles. And interior angles are supplementary. So 4x plus 2x. 4x plus 2x. And they are interior angles. So they are supplementary, right? Their sum is 180 degrees. So 4x plus 2x, 6x. 6x is 180. Therefore, x is 180 divided by 6. So divide 180 by 6, you will get the answer 30. Which option? D. So answer is x is 30. So this calculation you have to do. And as it is a multiple choice question, calculation. Problem set 2.2, second question. In the adjoining figure, line P is parallel to line Q and line T and line S are transversals. Find measure of angle X and angle Y using the measures of angles given in the figure. So what is given here, children? Which lines are parallel? Line P, that is line P is parallel to line Q. These two lines are parallel. And here we are having two transversals. Line T is also a transversal. Line S is also a transversal. And we have to find the measure of angle X and measure of angle Y. And given measures are there. One is 40 degree and one is 70 degree. So with the help of these given measures, we will find measure of X and Y. So solution. That is, first thing we have to mention, what is given? The line P is parallel to line Q. So we will write here, line P is parallel to line Q. And T is a transversal. So here two transversals are given. So we have to mention which transversal we are taking. So here we are taking line T, that is a transversal. And here we will take this W. So this we have to take. So when you will be drawing the sum, draw the figure and draw this angle W. Now what relation measure angle W and 40 is given, right? 40 degree. So this with the help of T transversal, you can see what is given, 40 degree. Now what relation we are having, measure angle W is equal to 40 degree. The reason is corresponding angles. And properties of corresponding angles is, that is, corresponding angles are congruent. So we got measure angle W, that is 40 degree. Okay, now X and W. So measure angle W plus measure angle X is equal to 180 degree. Why they are 180 degree? Because they are angles in a linear pair. They are angles in a linear pair. Right? So we have to solve this equation. Measure angle X is equal to 180 degree minus measure angle W. And that is measure angle X is equal to 180 minus 40. So subtract, children. 180 minus 40, you are getting 140. So measure angle X is equal to 140. Now, for next value. Again also here we will be mentioning that which parallels we are taking. Parallels are P and Q. So we will be writing angle, that is line P is parallel to Q. So we have to mention here line P is parallel to line Q. Now which transversal we are taking? S. Line S is a transversal. So we have to see now this part. S is a transversal. Right? Now here we will be taking angle, that is Z. So here you take Z. This is our Z. So you have to take here, children, Z. Now what is the value of Z? Z is equal to 70 degree. Why? Because they are vertically opposite angles. And vertically opposite angles are congruent. Their measures are equal. So measure angle Z is equal to 70 degree. Now what relation Y and Z is having? Y and Z are interior angles. They are inner side of the parallel lines. And same side. They are interior angles. So measure angle Y plus measure angle Z is equal to 180. Because interior angles are supplementary. Now measure angle Y is equal to 180 degree minus measure angle Z. And measure angle Z is 70. So 180 minus 70. Subtract, children. 180 minus 70. It is 110. So we got the value. Measure angle X is equal to 140. Measure angle Y is equal to 110. So this is the way we have to solve which lines are parallel and which is the transversal we are taking. So as an assignment, same sums you have to do once again. Okay, so this is your assignment. Same sums, do it once again. So we will stop here and we'll continue the next lesson. Thank you, children. Take care of yourself. Sayonara.